Okay, greetings, falling on the name of the Most High God, Jah, Rastafari, Ali Selassie I, elect of God, conquering land of the tribe of Judah, King of Kings of Ethiopia, His Imperial Majesty, in and through Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus, the Christ, Jesus Christos. Now, this will be a psalm. So now, Ye David Mez. See if we can fit this. Ye David Mezmur. Actually, Med. We're trying to practice. Amarin, so metal, ashre. The ah, maybe another ah, but metal ashre, which is the Psalm of David, 110. Now, well, actually, if one's care to be metal, and Asher. So, yeah, David Mezmur metal Asher, which is Psalm David 110. Exiaber get ayin telatoch echn le egrich mik emecha eskader glich dress bek enye tek emete alewe. Exiaber yehalechne betre ketseon yilklichal bet elatoch echn mekakel giza keant egar ket mobe chaylech en bek edusan berhan. Keat ebia kokeb isk edmo kehot weltehuch in de melket sedik shirat ant elezalalem kachne nech blo exiaber mali ait set setem exiaber bek enech nekisht atne bek wet awe ken yik etek et ach ewal beahizab mekakil Yefirdal Reisa watch in him Yabizal Besefi Mudrilai Rasochne Yik etek et al Bemenget kefesashi Wichayet et al Slezi Ras kef Yelal. So now we're just trying to motivate ones to, you know, and helps us practice putting ourselves in the spot like that. So now, going forward, so now we have the in Psalm of David, Psalm 110. The Lord said to my Lord, so Father, Son, sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. Okay, let's actually. We're under the impression that these visuals actually do help, and so we're gonna, you know, we're attempting to bring forth another vision concerning Psalm 110. So now, the Lord, see, is that even visible? Okay, the Lord said to my Lord, sit in my right hand. So there's already a trinity, because my Lord. So, this is me. See, is that visible? Okay, excuse me for that, but, appears like it's, okay, there, that's better. Okay, so my would be David. Lord. Oh, my bad. I was actually saying that wrong, but still, nonetheless, it is still the Trinity, because the Lord. So, because the Lord says to his Lord to sit in his right hand, we're gonna assume that this Lord is Abba Father. So Father says to the Lord of David, sit in my right hand. So this being the right, this being the left, and this will be David. Now continuing forward, it reads, oh well, actually, until I make thine enemies thy footstool. So what is the footstool? The footstool is earth. Earth is footstool. And actually, this is a symbol for earth, I think. So, continuing forward, it reads, the Lord shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Rule thou in the midst of thine enemies. So now we have Zion, Sion, a resting place. So there's a rod that comes down from Zion. And rule thou in the midst of thine enemies. So in the midst, we have one ruling out of the midst, and we'll say this is this encirclement is the enemies. Continuing, so now this rod is actually is also eventually going to bud, and bring forth fruit. So now continuing, it reads, thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power, in the beauties of holiness, from the womb of the morning thou hast the dew of thy youth. So now from the womb, from Malkut, from the matrix, the female wants to create, and thus from the womb, we are brought into this material, this existence. So now continuing, let's see, the dew. We kind of forgot what, but water. Okay, nonetheless, continuing. Well, we could actually even say like a mushroom. For some reason, that came to mind. Mushrooms depend on the tree. Let's say this is the tree. Depend on the tree to get the nutrients that it needs to survive, and the tree as well requires from the mushroom certain nutrients, and so it's a cycle. And an interesting thing is it catches the dew, it catches the rain or the water from the tree and maintains it. So if that helps, we give thanks. If not, then let us go on forward. So now, the Lord hath sworn and will not repent. Thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. So now, thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. Now, the sworn. The oath. There's been a promise. There's been an oath of salvation, we're gonna say. And one of the first oath that was given via the Almighty was to Noah when he set up the boat. So So just keep that in mind. Verse 5 reads, "The Lord at thy right hand shall strike through kings in the days of his wrath." So now this striking, we're pretty sure that this is probably speaking about Abba Father Haile Selassie first, because the rod of righteousness is actually the tree. It is Yeshua, the Mashiach, but he came as a sacrifice, so that we could all be saved. But it is Christ in his kingly character that comes with the eye of flaming fire, that brings forth the day of vengeance, destruction day, D-Day, and piercing. Well, what does it say here? It says the Lord at thy right. So actually, one is at the right of the other, and the other is at the right of the other. So, if that makes sense, the Lord at thy right hand shall strike through kings in the day of his wrath. So his imperial majesty strikes through kings in the day of his wrath. The end of all monarchies. It says he shall judge among the heathen. He shall fill the places with the dead bodies. It shall wound the heads over many countries. World War II. Now, he strikes his imperial majesty, the mighty Trinity strikes with a rod, with the rod of Yeshua, in the name of Yeshua, in righteousness. He doth make war in righteousness. And so, in the day of his wrath, strike through. And so we've represented that already. And now it says, he shall drink of the brook in the way. Therefore shall he lift up the head. So that's the promise. No longer shall I destroy, the earth with a flood. And so this promise of salvation is the sign is a bow, a war bow, a rainbow as well. But the last verse says, therefore shall he lift up the head. So man fell, and one way that we chose to explain this, well, let's do this. So now with the cross, the head is lifted up. And so the head is lifted up, and this is heaven. So this is, in a sense, the crucifixion or the cross, the arms, and the head will be raised, and all that which thought to be high will be brought down low, and that which was low will be brought up high. And so, from the womb, after making the enemies his footstool upon the cross, I guess we'll make it like a little figure. We are brought back up to Christ's head. But one last interesting feature is that promise with the bow. So now we have a we'll represent this bow in this fashion, in this manner. So we have the bow. And well, actually, this would have let's finish this circle. So if one could see, we have the eye of the Most High. And so we've been deceived, and so we were brought down low with a punch. and we being the centerpiece of the eye, the pupil, the apple of your eye. The eye being hit, you can picture man falling down to Sheol. And then the promise of salvation is that boat rescuing us. And the way to represent it, you see, when you strike an eye, when you punch a person in the eye, what the reaction is that the pupil or the actual eye, it kind of like it's pulled back, but not necessarily pulled back, but wrapped, like kind of like conceals itself, wraps itself kind of like an inward motion to protect the eye. And then there's a retractable part of the eye that closes to kind of protect it. So there's kind of like a, you know, like a kind of like swooping inwards. And so once it's hit, and that's probably what we should have showed first, but this is the fall, the depression, the fall. And we could see a type like ricochet, they say, or something like that. But you hit the eye, it bends inward, and then Jah comes and with that promise of salvation, and then we are once again lifted up. So we're kind of just experimenting with this form of teaching, if one could see that. But that's pretty much the conclusion to this, to Psalm 110. So, see if we remind anything. Yeah, so, okay, we'll leave it at that. This is the eye. And so, we receive, we don't know if we should even do this, but, this is the way in which we receive light, right? And that would kind of pretty much finish off the tree of life. Kind of like that. If it makes sense. If not, well, forgive me. Alright, we'll pause right there. We tried. Shalom.